Welcome back to Vikings Game Plan from the TCO studios. It's Paul Allen. Happy this week to be joined by Ron Johnson. We'll see him later with Winning Formula. Ron, of course, with Vikings Game Day Live on Fox 9 and Vikings Fan Line at FM 100.3 KFAM. We're going to take a look at some Seattle Seahawks film. At the end, a rough and tumble defense, but we begin with one of the very best, Russell Wilson, and this offense. Take it away.
You hear about Russell Wilson getting outside the pocket, and it's the second play with him that matters the most because he can create plays with his feet. And what you'll see here is a linebacker just covering him man-to-man. And he's spying Russell Wilson right there. Yeah. Look at that space. Nobody's covering DK Metcalf. Why? Because the linebacker that was supposed to cover that space had to evacuate because he was scared Russell Wilson was going to run. And DK Metcalf makes a catch that a lot of people didn't think he could do. Right. He's having a pretty good rookie season.
At the end of this, by the way, the hit at the end by 41, though. Watch this go. And
he held onto the ball, though. He completed the catch.
Well, you think he
so
did
that's
it?
The key.
Well, that's what DK does.
But here, you'll see this with Tyler Lockett. Same thing. Russell Wilson is just going to create time in the pocket. The last play, he had 7 seconds to throw the ball.
Yeah.
Now what you'll see here, there's nobody out there.
What
so most quarterbacks would have took off running.
Yeah.
He sees that the only thing there is his receiver's already at the first down marker. There's no point in me taking a hit. Brett Favre would have thrown the ball across his body. Russell Wilson throws
the
ball.
Stop that. What about this guy? What are we doing there?
It's man-to-man coverage. The minute he sees Russell Wilson scramble right, he knows that there's no reason to run there.
Yeah.
He knows somebody's going to have to account for him. And this is just playing together for so long. Tyler Lockett knows, okay, Russell Wilson's probably still going to come back to me. Let me get open. And he gets open.
Across the body, though.
Hey, and he made the throw, made the catch. And that's just another thing that he can do. Now here, Jaren Reed, he's a man.
Mm-hmm.
And these defensive linemen with four down, that's just a simple cross.
Let me quickly pause here on Vikings Game Plan for a Puna service announcement. With Jadeveon Clowney, Bobby Wagner, and Russell Wilson, you got a lot of big names here. I'm going to point out this 97 who's in this clump. Puna Ford, you better get to know Puna Ford right now. Remember, I told you that.
And what'd you see Puna Ford do? Perfect twist. Nobody's trying to get too aggressive. Center and guard just miscommunicate. Strip sack, fumble, touchdown, Jadeveon Clowney.
What are we doing?
And that's simple. You'll see from the back end,
what
they have to account for is when the guard sees his guy leave and the center feels his guy leaving,
you
take the next guy. Well, what does the center do? Scared of Puna Ford?
Yeah.
He's still looking for Puna Ford. And he's like, oh, wait a minute. My guy was Reed.
They got in there so quickly, Garoppolo couldn't even execute the naked boot.
Nothing. And then touchdown right there to Jadeveon Clowney. And they're aware of the boots, and that's what they want to try. Same thing. That's a four-man rush.
Yeah.
Here's another four-man rush, but there's a four-man rush with one guy doing all the work. 6'8", 310-pound, first-round draft pick out of Notre Dame.
Yeah.
He can do nothing with this man named Jadeveon Clowney.
Whoa.
He walks him back.
And Clowney is better known for his speed. But that's power right there,
I mean,
Ronald.
Look at that. He just walks him back to the quarterback. Another strip sack.
Yeah.
And this is in the same game. So they are preparing to set you up with different moves. They have a twist, and then they come back with just a bull rush.
Yeah.
And here you go here. The biggest key to this play is going to be counting the box.
Okay.
So there's a seven-man box. Jameis Winston knows he only has six guys to protect. Why? Mm-hmm. Because his tight end is in the route. So he knows he can't help him. So he's counting six. This guy, when you hear guys on TV yell, Mike 54, this is his Mike backer. So his Mike backer tells him that one, two, three backers we have to account for.
But wait, this is a Jameis L, if that's the case, by not changing the protection
Correct.
With the tight end.
Correct. But that's what Jameis Winston assumed, and we'll see from the back end that the running back could account for those two backers, and this backer, he's hoping, is covering that tight end.
Okay. I'm excited to see what happens. hey!
Sack and a nail.
Get out of there.
And we'll see
now,
here.
Well, hold on here. Bobby Wagner's one of the best linebackers in the NFL, and Jadeveon Clowney is standing up here. What are we doing?
So he's accounting for Jadeveon Clowney. His count, those seven. He's saying, this is my mic. This backer, you have him to him.
Okay.
So the mic, he's counting one, two, three guys. He's just saying we're going to protect.
Okay.
I have one, two, three blockers.
Yeah.
So those six are taken out. This guy here is the key to the play.
Gotcha.
He has to understand that those three are now in the count. If this guy comes, Wagner, that's my guy.
Right.
Of course, he picks wrong because he's in Tampa. And the tackle is the one who realizes last minute, like, wait a minute, I could have helped, but he couldn't help him.
Yeah.
And what happens? Sack.
Well, now, in a game where Russell Wilson is the A topic, as Ron just pointed out so adroitly, this Seattle defense is no joke. Going to be quite the challenge for the Minnesota Vikings.